What was something you thought was serious business as a little kid that you now realize was just plain silly? When I was maybe 4 or 5, I cried because my mom's homemade lemonade was clear instead of deep yellow like the lemonade I saw in commercials on TV. My mother was a Vietnamese refugee and she had spent all year growing those lemons. When I was a boy, my parents served asparagus with dinner one night. As a kid, of course I wasn't going to eat a green vegetable. They tried to get me to eat it by telling me that it would make me grow hair. Of course, the implication in that statement was that it would make me grow hair on my chest and thus make me more manly. However, my little kid brain interpreted it'll make you grow hair as you'll grow long hair and you'll turn into a girl. I spent the next several years desperately avoiding asparagus out of the fear of turning into a girl. Now I love asparagus, and I'm very hirsute. My parents used to make me eat squash and zucchini all the time and I hated it and threw huge temper tantrums and told them it was hurting me. I thought that I was being a melodramatic kid until just this year when I gave them another try. Turns out I'm allergic. My mom always told me to get home when the street lights came on. I, therefore, believed she turned them on just to let me know it was time to go home. I figured she must have been pretty lucky to be the one allowed to control all the lights in town. I wondered if I'd ever get to know which switch did it. It seemed like a huge responsibility. When my teacher told me it would go on my permanent record that I did something bad, I actually thought that there was a permanent record and that potential employers when I was like 40 would care that I talked in class in first grade. Yes, I got in some relatively serious trouble in about fifth grade and was so terrified that I would have a hard time getting into high school. Once, I was watching Barney on television and they had a guest on the show who was playing the piano. He wore a long tailcoat tuxedo and looked really spiffy. A few weeks later my mom told me that I was going to start piano lessons the next day, and I freaked out that I didn't have a tailcoat tuxedo to wear. I thought I was going to look like an idiot on the piano stand without the proper, fanciful attire. What sort of foul varmint attempts to play the piano without a tailcoat tuxedo? I cried. I was convinced that as soon as you were an adult, you were handed a checkbook. And as everybody knew, checkbooks were dispensaries of limitless money. And balancing the checkbook was an act of wizardry. My Wishbone fan club was super serious business. I forced my friends to join, and made them sing the Wishbone song over and over until they had it memorized. I bet they hated me, haha. Knock knock, opens peephole. What's the story? Wishbone, opens door. Based on the words of multiple grade school teachers, I thought my difficulty in learning cursive would cause grave heartache later in life. When I was in fourth grade, my teacher gave me a hard time because even though I learned cursive just fine, my handwriting was messy. That was in the 94-95 school year, and aside from signing my name, I haven't used cursive since. Everybody wants stuff written in print now. After all, I'm an adult, and adults don't need sippy cups and balloons tied to their wrists. Truly poetic. Also, you sound like the world's sweetest, most hilarious kid. I took things very seriously. Growing up was always a solemn duty and my mom used to be about me going out and playing like a normal kid for once. When I was 7, I pooped in my pants in the last few minutes of school because of a sudden and unexpected burst of unbridled energy. As I sat and hovered over my seat as to not squish the poo around, my thighs burned and I sweated profusely. I thought that if anyone found out, my life would be over. 20 years later, if I came across a 7-year-old who accidentally pooped in his pants, I'd be like, "Oh man, that's cool. You'll get better at holding it in." When I was a kid, I could never understand why my dad let other cars overtake us while we were driving along. It's a race, dad. Crap. I legitimately thought mental retardation was contagious and would often make a big show out of holding my breath whenever a handicapped person was near. I probably looked so insensitive, but I just didn't know what the heck was going on. I did the same with fat people. When we were staying at a hotel once when I was a kid and the TV wasn't working, just snow and static, and my mom said there must be a bug in the TV, I didn't sleep that night, freaking terrified of how big that bug, insect, must be to disable the TV. Another one, When I was about 5-6, there was a kid in my class who still to this day had more freckles than I've ever seen on another human being, and yes, bright red-orange hair as well. One day my mom said, "Oh look, you're getting a few freckles." I bust into tears and ran into the bathroom to look in the mirror, thinking it was only a matter of time before I was gonna turn into an exact copy of the kid in my class. It must have took me 30 minutes to chill out after my mom explained that it would not happen like that. I was not a clever child. The ginger. It's contagious. How has nobody said this yet? Swearing. Used to be the biggest deal when I was 7. Couldn't even say heck. Swore that I'd never ever say a single swear word as long as I lived. This was back when I didn't actually know that swears had meanings. Thought they were just nonsense words that you weren't allowed to say. When I found out the meaning of the F word, I felt as though the whole world had just been explained. People said it because they didn't realize how bad it was, because they didn't know what it meant. Told a kid in my class at the playground this theory, then told him the meaning of the word. He waited 5 seconds, then said it. I remember losing all faith in humanity that day. Oh, goodness. When I was in first grade, "You're stupid" was just about the worst insult you could possibly dish out, and saying "shut up" was pretty much a capital offense. When crossing through parking lots at the end of my mom's hand, at about 5 YO, I thought it was extremely important that I hold up my hand to approaching traffic, to signal them to stop. My mom had just given birth to my little sister, so my mom was often pushing a stroller while leading me, and I felt like I was protecting her and the baby. Now, I'll sometimes see a kid do the same, and I just smile and give them a wave as I wait for them to pass. It's funny to see yourself in little strangers. That's so funny because a little girl just did this to me yesterday. She had this look on her face like she was afraid I wouldn't see her with her hand out, and would run over her whole family. Truly shocked this is not the top answer. Birthday parties. Being invited to someone's birthday or not was a huge freaking deal in elementary school. It was pretty much an "I don't like you" if you weren't invited to a birthday party. So much stress and self-hate when I didn't get invited to Poppy McPopular. Not a real name. S birthday party. I just realized, not only did I never get invited to a single birthday party throughout elementary school, I never even knew when of it when my classmates had a birthday. They all must have kept it secret from me. My dad bought new rocks for landscaping, and one day as I went home I saw one shiny rock that was broken in half. Inside of it, what I thought, was crystal. It literally looked like crystals. I thought, what if these other rocks had the same composition and started banging breaking these small new rocks with bigger rocks. I did this for months on end, breaking rocks in half looking for crystal, and found a few rocks with them, or what I thought at the time. I pee off my dad because I got a bunch of loose rocks spread out all on the yard, and in the grass, which would be a bee to mow when rocks were everywhere. My biggest surprise though, I broke all these rocks without safety glasses on. How do I still have eyes? I have no idea. We used to do that at school, and occasionally someone would find a real geode. The principal came out at recess to help almost every day. At the end of kindergarten, I found an unfinished assignment in my desk. I threw it away, but was terrified that I would have to repeat the year. No one noticed. The three things that were super serious to me as a child were crayons. I despise sharing my crayons because other kids would always smash them while coloring, and I always insisted on maintaining a sharp point at all times. I had to rotate the crayon all the time to keep my points sharp, and I absolutely hated using broken crayons, and those hard colorers broke them. Barbies. I loved playing with my Barbies, but I was very serious about keeping them in mint condition. I would get extremely upset if they were not put back in their original clothes after we were done playing, or if someone messed up their hair. In fact, one of my neighbors took down Cinderella's hair and I could never get it to look the same. There's still a little resentment there. Books. I was always very careful with my books, but would happily let my friends borrow them. Once I let my friend borrow my books and her little sister colored all over it with a highlighter. I was completely distraught and cried for an entire day about the destruction of my beloved book. I'm still super protective of my books. I try to never lend them out, because getting them back can be a challenge and I want them to remain in good condition. I had this T-Rex toy that my parents got for me at a yard sale when I was 7. It was one of those Land Before Time dinosaurs you got from Papa John's. This toy was the first toy I ever got attached to. I played with it for a year, and one day I was playing too rough with T-Rex and I ripped his leg off. It wasn't repairable. I cried and my parents searched for one for months with no luck. However, 11 years later when I graduated high school, one of my graduation presents was another T-Rex. I'll probably give it to my kid if I have one day. My little sister always wanted a doll called Baby Alive. This was late 70s, but never got one. My mother gave her one for her college graduation. When I was 6 or 7, my teacher made me move seats because I was originally next to my best friend and we were talking too much. My heart was in my mouth when I went home, certain that my parents would know, certain that this was akin to some great criminal act. I was on edge for days trying to figure out whether to be honest and feel the might of their wrath or try to keep my poker face. I never did tell them in the end, but I highly doubt the consequences would have been as serious as I imagined. I also used to buy chocolate milk instead of normal milk at lunchtime, even though my mom expressly told me not to. I felt like a secret agent every time. I remember being very upset when my mom wouldn't put my hair in ribbons. I was 6. This led to a lot of fuss from me, and I was a few minutes later for school. My mom threatened to tell my teacher why I was late and how silly I had been. I marched in and told the teacher myself, as I was outraged at the injustice of it all and that my hair wasn't pretty. I also, rightly, pointed out that a lot of time could have been saved if she'd just done my hair. I wasn't a brat really. Ah yes, the typical "I don't have time to do this or the other," but they have time to stand there and argue with you instead. I can't remember anything from being a little kid, but when I was 16 I was convinced it was my duty to swear a blood oath against Microsoft and see the company destroyed so that all could bask in the greatness of Linux. I use Windows 7 now. I was so concerned you'd say Mac. My eye-rolling muscles were all warmed up and ready to go. Algebra. In the third grade, I would look at my 9th grade brother's algebra work and see, solve for x, 3x equals 21, and I would sit there and pray to God I would never have to learn it. Now I try to comprehend how I could ever not understand basic algebra. I one day hope to understand calculus at the level I understand algebra. That son of a bitch is so dang useful, but I can't get the hang of it. In kindergarten we had quiet time when we laid on the floor to rest sleep. The best rester got to wake everybody up by tapping them with a wand. I wanted to do that so badly, but I could never fall asleep. I was terribly upset, mostly because I didn't want to let Miss Cozzle down. I'd get so worked up I'd feel sick and wet my pants once. I also hid in the supply room so Miss Cozzle wouldn't see I wasn't sleeping. I was forgotten more than once. When I was little, I used to think getting fired meant your boss actually ended your life. Like one day, your boss got tired of your crap and burned your cubicle to smoldering ashes with you inside. This was all okay, because she was your boss. Your username concerns me, given your story. When I was younger, around 5 or 6, I used to live in a house with a garden full of this type of plant that I believed to be wheat. So naturally, I decided to pick all the plants and attempt to sell it to my dad so you can eat it, or so he tells me. I was so utterly offended when he burst out laughing that I told him I'd sell it to my mum instead, and refused to talk to him at dinner. I used to love walking on those concrete dividers in parking lots and jumping from one to the next. I thought I was so dang talented that one day I would be in the Olympics. Mum pretended to be impressed, but I could tell she wasn't, and I couldn't understand why. As a kid, I always thought being on time to my cartoons was the right thing to do. I would count down the seconds and sit right as the clock struck the correct time. I thought I was so badass. Whenever I sat down a minute before or after the time, I'd cry. Hey, I do that for work now. One time I thought I had outgrown the need to keep my eyes open as I rode my bike. I think I was trying to impress some girl by being mature. So I went down a hill with my eyes closed and smashed into a car. I bet that girl didn't even notice my eyes were closed. I did that one to but not to impress a girl. I just did it thinking that if I'm good enough to ride my bike, I can do it with my eyes closed. I crashed into someone's hedges and the neighbors tried to help me, but I refused because I was crying. I walked my bike back all the way home crying. Hide behinds. Fictional buttholes my family made up to scare me off from going out after it was dark. They threw garments at you. I had no idea what a garment was. I don't remember my exact age, but my first year of Little League, we were having a fundraiser. We were all given 20 tickets for a spaghetti lunch. The coach made a big deal about how we were responsible for the $2 or whatever each ticket cost. If we lost them, then we'd have to pay the league. I stuffed them into my pocket and the next day found that my pants had been washed and all the tickets had been ruined. I hadn't sold a single one. Quick math. I owed the league $40. I was so embarrassed by my situation that I never told my parents and just simply stopped going to Little League. I never played baseball again. I even remember after this incident that when I would go to see a cousin's game, I was always afraid everybody was looking at me and thinking I was the thief who stole $40. Jeez, what a knucklehead I was. How concerned I was with looking cool, in general. If I had simply done whatever I wanted, I would have probably ended up being a lot cooler for real in high school. This includes the typical making fun of people, excluding people, etc. My parents told me that fart was a horrible swear word and I got my mouth washed with soap every time I said it. HMMHRRMMM. When my mother told me that fart was a bad word, I invented a new word, which my family still uses it, actually. I would get very upset when my friends and I would play with Barbies, and they didn't have realistic stories. Their stories would be happy and illogical. Mine were cold and realistic and brutal. At one point, my brother watched me make a story with a single mom and an only child. The mother wasn't doing so well, and they had to sell their house, and she ended up blaming the little girl and beating her to death. The cops came and found no evidence of foul play. I made the mom commit suicide into my blue blanket of imaginary ocean. I was like, 6. I also ended up killing many of my friends' Barbies because they were being ridiculous. No, Amy, your doll can't have a unicorn. That's not how life works. My mom took me to a child psychologist. Turns out they watched too much CSI around me. My mom was part of an organization called Big Sisters or something like that, where you become somewhat of a big sister to a girl in need. She already had had a little sister before, but that was before I was born. So when I was little, my mother volunteered again, and let's say the girl's name was Susan. Susan was in a bad situation with her parents. She lived in a small house, and her mother was always ill. I don't remember too specifically all that went down, but Susan would come over and play with us a lot. She was barely older than my two older sisters. Susan always talked to my mom, and they would sometimes discuss her situation, and how her mother always had ulcers. As a little one, I didn't understand what ulcers were exactly, except that you could get them from worrying too much and it was your stomach acid eating through the wall of your stomach and creating hole. I imagined a gaping hole the size of my fist. I also didn't know how big your stomach was. So yeah, I was a bit of a worrywart about homework and that, so now I was worried about getting an ulcer, which, you know, made it even worse. TLDR. A friend's mom had ulcers and I was afraid I was going to get one. When I was 5, I was playing around with my grandpa's electronics cause I wanted to watch a movie. So of course I was doing this after I had been told not to touch or play with anything. My grandpa found me and got mad at me and said not to touch it again or he was going to skin me alive. Later at a family dinner, I quietly asked my mom how many layers of skin we had and she asked me about what happened and I told her and started crying. I was afraid of my grandpa for a few weeks after that incident. When I was in like second grade, me and my friends got caught climbing around on the stalls in the bathrooms. We liked standing on the toilets and swinging from the bars and such just because it was fun. Well, we got sent to the principal's office and our crazy butt principal had the coaches from 3 high schools throughout our city come in and talk to us about how in high school we would have been expelled for vandalism. About how people get arrested for trashing public property, even though we never hurt anything. At the end of the day, she called my parents and my friend's parents. I practically pee myself coming home because I thought I would be in a ton of trouble, but my mom said that was the stupidest crap she had ever heard out of an adult person's mouth. Then she bought me ice cream. Winning. Buying a car. watching my dad buy a car in 1973. All the negotiating and then finding out it cost $3,000. A fortune. Taxes. I know they aren't necessarily silly or unimportant, but holy crap did I stress out about taxes. I didn't know how I would figure out how to pay file ETC and was certain that the government was going to arrest me and my family. I frequently asked my mom at age 7 if she would do them for me. Decades later. Thank you e-filing. D. When I was maybe 7, I realized I didn't know who I was going to marry when I grew up. So I curled into a ball under the dining room table and cried for a while. It was serious business to me. Charizard. I asked for a single Pokemon card for my birthday 1 year. Granted, a foil first edition Charizard is a freaking sweet victory. Getting Pokemon Ruby. I cried like a butthole for days until I got it. Then I could be like my friends. Still regret doing that, still feel guilty, but frick you, it's Pokemon. Pokemon's serious crap, man woman. When I was younger, I couldn't wait to turn 11 so I could get my Hogwarts acceptance letter and be carried off to Hogwarts by Hagrid and learn magic. Sigh, if only. When I was maybe 12 or 13, I made a solemn vow to myself that if I ever have children, I'm not giving them Harry Potter until they are already 11. Crap hurts, yo. There's plenty of good books to read in the meantime, but the disappointment when you're 11 and it's summer and the owl doesn't come. Talking to girls. I was too nervous to talk to girls through high school. I would have all of these internal panic attacks about how they would think I was lame or something. I was so afraid of rejection that I really didn't date anyone. In reality, I could have been pretty popular with the ladies if I simply started chatting with them. Yeah, I remember thinking that someday when I was grown up I'd be able to talk to girls without any problems. Someday it would be easy. H.A. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.